Bonjour tout le monde et bienvenue sur Irvin's French Class. Aujourd'hui, dans cette vidéo, we continue on the direct object complement concept and we are going to cover the COD pronouns. After covering their forms and uses in context, we will do some fun activities together to revise and practice. C'est parti! A pronoun is a grammatical word used to replace a noun that has already been mentioned in a text or a conversation. In this channel, we covered already the subject pronouns, for example, je, tu, il, elle, on, nous, vous, il, elle. See the link in the description. Today, we are looking at the direct object pronouns, those that come to replace the direct object complement. And by the way, if you need to brush up on the concept of direct object complement, please watch my previous video. Again, the link is in the description. Just very quickly, COD, complément d'objet direct, can be found in a sentence by taking the subject and the verb and ask the question qui, whom, for people, and quoi, what, for things. For example, je regarde un film. The question is, je regarde quoi? Answer is, un film, which is the direct object complement. Another example with people, j'aime mes enfants. The question is, j'aime qui? The answer is, mes enfants, which is the direct object complement. So, COD pronouns will come into the picture to replace COD already mentioned. Here is their form along with the translations. Me, te, le, la, l' apostrophe, which is the elision of both le and la, nous, vous, and les. If we bring back our previous examples, je regarde un film. Je regarde quoi? Answer is un film. That's the COD. So if I want to refer again to the movie, I will need to use a COD pronoun. Je regarde un film. Je le trouve intéressant. Similarly, j'aime mes enfants. If I want to refer again to mes enfants, which is the COD, I will then use the pronoun corresponding to the il plural form. J'aime mes enfants. Je les protège beaucoup. Let's change now slightly our examples. Je regarde une pièce de théâtre. The COD is une pièce de théâtre and is now feminine. I will therefore need to use the la pronoun. Je la trouve intéressante. For people, j'aime ma femme. Ma femme is the COD and is now feminine and singular. I will also need to use the la pronoun. Je l'aime. And see that the la, there is an elision because M starts with a vowel. You will need to use the L apostrophe. Je l'aime. By the way, you surely already use the COD pronouns without even knowing it. Je t'aime. The T apostrophe is te in front of the vowel. It refers to toi. J'aime qui? Toi. And the T apostrophe is a COD pronoun. In terms of their position regarding the verb, you have probably already noticed that they go immediately in front of the verb, in positive as well as in negative sentences. For example, you can repeat this after me. Je te remercie. Je remercie qui? Toi. Te is the corresponding COD pronoun. Je te remercie and is positioned right in front of the verb. Je te remercie. Negation, je ne te remercie pas. The te sticks to the verb. Je ne te remercie pas. Within infinitive constructions, such as the near future, the recent past, and with verbs like vouloir, pouvoir, etc., the pronouns come immediately before the infinitive. For example, Est-ce que tu vas faire tes devoirs demain? Within that question, devoir is the COD. Tu vas faire quoi? Tes devoirs. So, devoir is the COD. It's masculine and plural. So, if I want to refer back to devoir in the same conversation, I will use les, the les COD pronoun. So, est-ce que tu vas faire tes devoirs demain? Oui, je vais les faire demain. Or if it's negative, non, je ne vais pas les faire demain. In both cases, the pronoun is in front of the infinitive. All right, let's do an activity together to revise and practice. All you need to do is to complete the answers to the questions using COD pronouns to replace the nouns. And this activity is, by the way, also the opportunity to review several verbs that use direct object complements. Let's start with the first one. Est-ce que tu connais Pierre? Okay, Pierre, what's the corresponding pronoun to Pierre, which is the COD in here? Tu connais qui? Pierre. Le is the corresponding pronoun. Very good. Oui, je le connais. Ok. Numéro 2. Est-ce que tu veux inviter les voisins? Inviter qui? Les voisins. That's the COD. You need to replace it in the answer. Ok. With the corresponding pronoun. It's plural. You're going to use les. Très bien. Non, je ne veux pas les inviter. And you see here in the answer, that's an infinitive construction. The pronoun goes right in front of the infinitive. Je ne veux pas les inviter. Numéro 3. Est-ce qu'il doit aider ses parents? Il doit aider qui? Ses parents. That's the COD. Okay. The corresponding pronoun is again, yes, les. Oui, il doit les aider. Numéro 4. Est-ce qu'ils nous écoutent? Are they listening to us? Est-ce qu'ils nous écoutent? Negation, non. Ils ne... And here, what's the pronoun that you need to use? They don't listen to us. Ils ne nous écoutent pas. Très bien. Numéro 5. Est-ce qu'elle écoute souvent la radio? Est-ce qu'elle écoute souvent quoi? La radio, that's the COD that you need to replace. Radio is feminine, so the pronoun is la. Non, elle ne la écoute pas souvent. The verb starts with a vowel. You need to do the elision. Elle ne l'écoute pas souvent. 6. Est-ce qu'elle va regarder la télé ce week-end? Oui, elle va la regarder. Once again, that's the la pronoun you need to use and there is no elision here. 7. Est-ce qu'il garde les enfants? Est-ce qu'il garde qui? Les enfants, that's the COD. Non, il ne... What's the corresponding pronoun? Les, très bien. Il ne les garde pas. 8. Est-ce qu'elle cherche la solution? Oui, elle la cherche. Très bien. 9. Est-ce que tu m'aimes? Oui, je aime. So what's the pronoun you need to use? Je t'aime. Très bien. 10. Est-ce que nous laissons nos clés? Oui, vous les laissez. Perfect. Ok, nos clés, that's plural. Ok, vous les laissez. Voilà, c'est tout pour cette vidéo. Please answer in the comments that question. Est-ce que tu regardes mes vidéos? N'oubliez pas de mettre un pouce bleu et abonnez-vous. That's the best way to make sure you don't miss anything, especially the upcoming videos, to complete that series on the direct object complement. À bientôt, à plus, ciao!